Okay, Tracy, so I have to show you this because I have the instructions on my website how to make the yogurt. So after the instructions, I get like this quart mason jar out of 1 gallon of milk. I get about 4.5 of these. But what I do is I take half of it and I put it in a strainer. And I put this strainer over a measuring cup with a piece of cheesecloth in it, which I have hanging up because it's drying right now. Put that inside here over the bowl and I leave it overnight. And all the whey drains out. Here's the whey. Pure protein. This is 100% protein. So you can put it in soups or stews. You can add it back to a smoothie. And this is how my yogurt comes out. Sometimes I make it too thick and I have to put some of the whey back. Look at this. Now that's Greek style, but it's so thick that this I can actually use as sour cream. I can use it, I put dip mix in it and I use it as a dip. And what I normally do for the kids is I put it in a bowl, I put some honey on it, I drizzle some honey, and I put frozen berries on top. That's how my kids like it. You could, I have lemon extract or vanilla extract. You could put that in there, make it like a pudding. It's almost like a pudding or a custard. This loose stuff is what I use. See how it? I use that for smoothies, and Mario likes that, and Lily likes it now too. I have a Vitamix blender that I bought a long time ago, and all I do is I put yogurt, frozen berries, and a little bit of honey, and that's it. And I put it in the blender, and if it needs loosening, I either put juice, almond milk, or some of the whey. And I make smoothies, and Mario mostly drinks that in the morning because he's not a breakfast person. So you can do a lot. And I buy, like I said, I buy a gallon of organic milk because the other yogurts in the store all have corn syrup in them, and the ones that are organic are so expensive. It costs me for one size like this, it costs me the same amount it cost me for 1 gallon of milk, and I get like 4.5, 5 quarts. So if you want to make yogurt, it is so easy. And I could explain it to you if you want, but I do have it on the website. Leftover rice, I made rice pudding. It's for kind of a dessert. I didn't want all the rice to go to waste. I just added milk and sugar, cinnamon, and nutmeg. I actually used stevia. So this is what I do with the bananas when they're getting ripe and the kids haven't eaten them. I freeze them. This can go in a smoothie. And what I do is I also, for the baby, I cut them in thirds and I make banana pops. I make big pops for Mario. Mario, I've been doing that since he was teething. You just stick the banana on a stick, wrap it like that, put it in the freezer, and they love it. This is a leftover smoothie that Mario didn't eat, so now he has a smoothie pop. Yogurt, honey, berries, that's all. So this is my fermenting corner. I have pickled watermelon rind there, so that didn't go in the trash. And that's homemade apple cider vinegar. All the scraps from the kids eating the apples, the skins, because I have to peel them for the baby, and the cores, or apples that were starting to get brown or bruised. Water, apples, a little bit of sugar. You see the foam? I don't know if you can see the foam on top there. And I also added a little bit of organic vinegar, like a couple of tablespoons, the one that says with the mother in it to kickstart it. That in the corner is a SCOBY. It's a starter for kombucha. So when I make a batch of kombucha, I throw one of those little slimy discs in and it turns it into kombucha. This is leftover pickle juice because when I make my own pickles, sometimes I'll use the old dill pickle juice. I have not bought a bottle of salad dressing in 15 years. All I do is I just use my own. I use olive oil, vinegar, and I throw in some salt, pepper, spice, whatever I want. This is store-bought, but I actually make my own ketchup. I buy the tomato paste, and it's just tomato paste, vinegar, garlic, and onion powder. And instead of sugar, I use honey. Put it in a pot, simmer it for about a half an hour, cool it, and I make my own. And I save these bottles and I put my own in there. Because this organic stuff, unless it's on sale, it could be expensive. I make my own iced tea, mostly because I try to stay away from a lot of sugar. And I put stevia in it. But all it is 2 bags of tea. Fill it up with hot water. Cool it. Put a little lemon juice in there and either sugar or stevia or whatever you want. Costs nothing. Of course, being the Italian family we are, we do pickled peppers, you know, the stuffed peppers, and we do the eggplants and stuff. And as long as they're under the oil, they stay on the shelf. And these are 1 year old and they're still good. As long as they're under the oil, they don't go bad. Homemade pickles, easy. Those I actually did last year. Actually, it says 2014. And I just opened them the other day because the baby wanted a pickle. I don't know if you could see much in here, but I have a lot of canned stuff. We can things when we can. If we get too much, we either freeze or can them. That takes a process and you have to have a canner, but you could always borrow it. I let somebody borrow mine once just so they could do a pile of canning. And it'll stay in here forever. As long as you do it right, it stays. This was a coat closet, and we turned it into a pantry. This is on the door, but it was a shoe rack. All the spices, and I keep the jars because when I harvest my spices, I put them in the bags, crunch them up, and then I'll put them in jars so I can put them in the kitchen.